I love it. Love it.
Okay, so right. So we're doing a reaction. This is right. We're back to Tool.
All right.
This is off their 2019 album. And the album is called Fear Inoculum.
Fear Inoculum.
Fear Inoculum.
Is that going to do with eyesight? Oculum.
I think inoculum, like an injection.
Is that not what you put
inoculation?
The, yeah.
Is that not what you put the drinks up?
I'll have a double.
So yeah, Fear Inoculum. This is, 2019, their newest inoculum album. And this song is called Pneuma. P-N-E-U-M-A.
Pneuma.
Pneuma.
Oh.
Okay.
Right. There you go now again with the soundscape. Love it. It's almost like a Sergio Leone's introduction to a Western. It's on a rattlesnake.
Could be.
Huh?
It could be.
But do you know what's lovely? It's his tempo on it, coming down. You know, and I think, I'm not too sure, that could be an effect, the chorus effect. It's beautiful and lovely effect on the guitar.
Well... It's music. It's score again, isn't it?
Mm.
It is score again. But I'm getting Death Valley, Rattlesnake, and a posse of horses. Am I in drugs? Do I need to be in drugs?
Yeah, but it does work.
Which?
Both.
Both. It is so cinematographic, isn't it? Seriously. John Lee long shots. Mm-hmm. You know that.
You know what I love about that? And as a musician, I love hearing the bass player, but I love hearing the kick of the drum that's going with him. Oh, it's unreal. Remember the last time we were talking about Tool, and you mentioned some like Jesus Christ Superstar.
Said in the comments, yeah.
That is something like a song from Jesus Christ Superstar. Something, the kicking and starting.
Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Thank you. Whoever the sound engineer is.
That's Stu's introduction in Jesus Christ Superstar, and also Simon the Zealot's piece in the desert.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm not saying they've copied it.
No.
But that's what I'm getting. But I'm getting desert, firstly.
Okay.
And mostly.
Yeah.
That introduction was like a Leone Western introduction.
I'll pause it here. Go on, no talk.
But that's what I got initially.
Yeah.
That sort of rattlesnakey thing. Immediately I said rattlesnake.
When you heard it.
Yeah. And I went, that's great. But it's so cinematographic. It really is.
Yeah.
And you've pulled back and you see a posse. And you see them riding. And it's almost like the Searchers, was it Lean? David Lean's magnificent long
shots. The Searchers.
The Searchers.
John Ford.
That was John Ford did that, didn't he? Yeah. But this sounds like... But
David Lean is like Lawrence of Arabia.
David Lean. Well, long shots as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But no,
epic,
Ford.
Epic.
Epic. Epic.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm getting.
But it,
and then back in again.
But it's...
I like it.
I definitely say whoever the sound engineer is, they should get an Oscar.
The Oscar is for sound engineer.
Yeah, if there's an Oscar for
a
sound
Grammy,
engineer.
Something.
It's just... Everything is just...
It's funny you went to Oscar and not Grammy. Yeah. Because the cinematographic nature of it.
Yeah.
Because you can see it, you know, but even give him a granny, whatever his granny wants. But unbelievable sound it was.
Give him his granny. Yeah.
I couldn't hear you. it's just, and when you were saying about the desert, I could nearly hear that, especially on the timpani, isn't it? Uh-huh. He has it, and it's tempo that goes down.
Terrific.
Yet the other fellow's still at that sound, you know. Unbelievable. Keep going.
Okay. Actually, if you want to, we'll pause it in between.
If you wish.
Whatever you want to do.
Yeah, it's lovely. Now, before we go on, I'm looking at you and I know it exactly. They're out of the desert, right? Where are they now on your mind with that part?
At night around a campfire.
No.
Where are you?
I can see.
This is a game of Google Maps.
I'm watching, I'm thinking about the desert and the
snake. And not that same blazing size with the beans.
No, it has come straight to the room in The Exorcist.
Oh.
You know, straight to that room.
That went quick.
Wow. You know, I know. But
I was more ritualistic
it's more exorcisms. You know, it's more of a chant. You know, it sounds like a chant.
That's why they're
running. But it's not a chant.
You went straight to the bedroom.
Straight to the bedroom of the exorcist. Where?
What is that? Your mother sucks cocks in hell. Is that bit?
No, your mother washes socks in hell. But that was nice. But no, I could see it. And do you know what it is? She's lying in the bed. The devil is there. But the sound is, you know, a chant.
It's slightly demonic.
I can't explain it to you.
You did explain it. No, you have explained it. And there's nothing more graphic than that scene in The Exorcist.
Yeah.
When Reagan's reeling in the bed and the priests are, poor Von Schnull, whatever his name is trying to appease the demon. But yeah, I didn't go there that quickly.
Well, it compels you. You don't want to do it. Christ compels. And you can hear that big chant in the background. That's I don't know. Maybe.
So is it sinister? Or you find that sinister?
Yeah. Well, I think it is.
It's foreboding for me.
It's
more foreboding than sinister. It's an incantation. But I don't know what's going to pop up, though.
What?
From the incantation.
We'll compare you.
Ooh.
Oh.
But it is. It's amazing we're speaking these terms rather than musical terms.
But
we're literally breaking down a score.
But yeah, mm-hmm. We're breaking down a score, but it goes to show you. But I've noticed on it that it's
I'm not be spoiling for people. It's just like
the music. Yeah, it's what we think of it.
People want to know, like people listening to this and watching will want to know what's coming to mind when you hear these songs. Because they're very expressive. Like
they're very
there's
very
a lot of meaning right. in
but
them.
But genuinely,
there's a lot
this is the first time I've heard this music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Second.
Maybe not this type of music, but I haven't heard. No, I've heard when we did the last ones. But as Chris said, don't look them up. You know, keep it as fresh.
I
haven't heard any of this stuff.
Well, I listened to a few.
Oh, you cheated.
On true earphones.
Right,
but this, to me, it's like a, as you say, it's a score of different
very
types of
much
movies.
So. I think
but,
so.
But very, very talented people.
Yeah.
Very talented people. It's just unbelievable.
And again, the vocalist or the vocalist and the narrative is not front forward. It's very much part of the soundscape.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The music, the orchestration, the sound is not there to serve the narrative. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But yet he's gone
with
it.
The vocal narrative.
He's gone with it when you hear the bump.
Yeah.
Every song
he's singing.
He's singing in it.
Every song has a story. Yeah. I mean, the first time as a kid, well, not that young, but hearing Hotel California, again, an epic, again, a narrative, again, a storyline, absolutely visualizing. Then other songs are simply for movement, for dance, for memory, and mostly memory. 3 minutes of just time.
Yes.
Just escapism. But this sort of stuff, and I don't like long introductions, get to the fucking point.
Yeah, yeah.
But this is acceptable, very acceptable, because it's opera.
It is.
It is.
It's opera.
It's yeah.
And, you know, if you went to see an opera and they start singing straight away, you'd be very upset. And so would the orchestra.
Exactly, yes.
And,
I know
and
what
the
you
conductor
mean.
And the composer.
You're right.
Because there's musicality in everything,
mm-hmm.
including the vocal.
And it builds a tension. It builds a suspense to...
Yeah,
absolutely.
I think this...
One of my favorite pieces of operatic aria is from...
Swan Lake.
The Cavalier Rusticana.
Offenbach.
Offenbach. No, he's chevy. And the Easter Prayer, which is a beautiful piece of music. And that takes forever to build. And then by the time the lyric comes in, it's practically over.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the whole soundscape.
Yeah.
Built around that moment of regret.
Yeah, yeah.
From the Cavalier Rusticana. What magnificent, wonderful.
But
I can't remember the old. I can't. Magni. I can't remember.
Yeah. Man and Butterfly.
Ah. But, that was Puccini.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Puccini. Oh,
but do you know what catches me on Tool?
When I'm zipper.
Yeah. When I'm listening to it, I can hear the desert, the exorcist. I'm waiting to see what's coming next.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
I'm way ahead of the song and saying, my God, what else?
Where are they
going to
go?
Do? What else can
how
they
many,
do?
How many minutes left in this track?
You're halfway.
Right, we get back.
Right. I should have brought popcorn.
Yeah.
Yes. But that, you know something? If I was going to see, we say it was on the cinema of Tool or watching videos, you just sit with your popcorn.
You see, I'm not compelled. Maybe if I were younger and much fitter, I might be compelled to move to, what do those young people call it, a mosh?
Mosh pit.
Mosh pit. I know it's not that young as age.
Well, they're not exactly a mosh type band.
No, but.
No.
I understand that people would move to this. I would quite happily sit down and just listen.
The funny thing, when I've seen them I've seen them twice. The funny thing is, it's not like a beat that's like a rhythm.
Beat.
It's not like a 4-4. You know, it's not like you can
move. Yeah, okay.
It's changing. You're like, you're off. Like
everything's changing.
It's off.
Yeah.
But and everyone's head in the audience is moving at a different tempo.
Well, that,
You know what I mean? Like, it's not like a, like, no, you can get it. I can't think of anything off the top of my head, but like usually there's like a riff where everyone's in unison banging their
head.
But with these, it's everyone's off. Like you're in tune with another beat in the song.
This person's over here doing
another movement. Everyone's off, but it works.
Are you familiar with, bloody hell, I can't remember the composer again, Carmine Burana? Da 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 boom da 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 da. And it's very much that vibe with me with that. You know, it was used for the Old Spice Act, and I think it was used in the Exorcist.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Was it a bit used in the Exorcist? I can't be sure. Or no, the Omen. The Omen. There you go now.
Yeah, demonic. See what I mean?
Demonic. Yeah, yeah.
But it brings us back to these, because you're expecting. It's
dramatic. It's epic.
It's a dramatic thing, well, you know.
A bit of trivia for you.
Yeah.
About the band. Well, one of the lead guitarist, his name's Adam Jones, and he used to work. He's worked on like the Terminator. He was a visual effects artist. Like right. He'd do hand sculpted like.
Is this the drummer?
No, lead guitarist. Worked in visual effects for years in big Hollywood movies.
Right, okay.
But so he's got a background in cinema. You know what I mean?
And epicness. And visuals.
Like he worked on Jurassic Park, like designing the dinosaurs, all this kind of stuff.
I didn't know you worked on Ballymac.
How does that correlate? Now, would you mind break that down for me?
I'm just in terms of like a cinematic link.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
Would that come into it? The Lawrence of Arabia.
I'm guessing he's a movie fan.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it comes into it.
It's
colored.
But it's down.
It's a sweep of the visualness. It's very evident to me.
Yeah.
But do you know what I love about it? Because you were saying about dance songs and all that.
And theatre.
Yeah, theatrical.
Very theatrical.
But they say that either a smell or a song can bring you back to a certain place.
Yeah.
Tool brings you everywhere.
Yeah.
It just brings you. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Like if I was to sit and put on what we're listening to now with Tool, I would go from a desert, I'd be sweating, into a room with a one shirt and God, Jesus Christ.
Don't be saying that again. Yeah, yeah.
You know, and then but I can't wait for the next bit. Will you hurry up?
Okay, so here we go. We'll make it to the end.
Yeah, man.
I love it. Love it.
Wow. No, this is my musician's part of it. Right? It's just, it's unbelievable. Now, what people would say, you know, that is incredible. When we got back into the part, there was a bass player, a guitar player. There was a couple of congas there just tapping away in the background. I think, I'm not too sure if he's using a keyboard or a mug.
I'll get to this in a second. Wait till see what we're going to do next.
And he's using this thing and it's all, and the bass player. And then the drummer decides, I'll take the snare of the snare drum, you know. And there's not that snare sound. And then all of a sudden, the guy that's playing the mug or whatever he's playing just fades away out of it.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes on. And then someone else fades out. And I'm saying, and like, when you look at it, for maybe 7 or 8 bars, it's just one bar of music.
But yeah.
It's the way that it's put together.
Yeah, yeah, it's the way it's put together. Face down mic towards
are that band looking for a bass player?
See, I wouldn't have the technical wherewithal. Oh,
but no, you can just
to understand.
That. That's what I love about
what's a mug?
Listening. A mug is, do you remember?
Is that the synth?
It's a synthesizer, mm-hmm. but it's called a mug. Do you remember that Son of My Father?
Yeah,
that. It came out in the 70s.
Right, but yeah, I got it.
Maybe they have that, I don't know.
Like, I know the guitarist has like a wee, he has a keyboard. They each have their own wee rig beside them, yeah. as well as they're, like, they're all making
sounds.
They're making sounds.
Incredible.
You know, the next, I'll show you, go on, I'll get to it.
Yeah, well, I just choreographed that last piece.
I can
in
see.
In my wee head. Again,
I seen Alvaro smiling during a bit of that.
Circus of Lie. And then the choreography. So one of my favorite musicals, and I know you're going to find it ironic, is Hair, the musical. Rock, tribal rock opera that was deemed in 69 when it
this
came
is
out.
Very tribal.
Yeah, so tribal rock opera. So then when they made the movie with the late, great Treat Williams, God love him, in 79, the sequence, the choreographed sequence for the movie, for the Hare Krishna sequence, was dynamic. When he drops LSD during a protest in Central Park. And he...
LSD.
And then he goes straight into a dream sequence with Beverly D'Angelo's character. This is the guy from The Killing Fields. I can't remember anybody's name. I got half-timers. And that whole sequence. And even though harmonica is not the same, but the dance sequences, the movements are just completely redressed. That last sequence we were listening to. Because it's so evocative.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what this music is, evocative. Very evocative.
Yeah.
And yeah, I find all music, as I told you before, my go-to music in the car, at home, and it's baroque. I listen to a lot of baroque music. I don't listen to very much lyric.
Mm-hmm.
But then if I go to pop, it's 60s pop. And if it's 60s pop, it's usually the female vocalists.
Yeah.
Particularly Dusty and Cilla Black. That's sort of where I veer. And then the male voice, I go a bit younger. 1950s, 60s, early 60s, Mel Torme, Matt Monro.
Yeah.
Who do I like? What's his face? Le Bise Classel Bell Size. What's his name?
Engelbert.
Engelbert Humperdinck. So they're the sort of voice I go, but for music. For music, I go to baroque because it is very baroque. It's very dramatic. It's very beatsy.
Yeah.
Okay. It's not pastorally Beethoven. That's a different thing altogether.
Yeah.
But for me, this is that.
Right.
Staccato. Okay. Well, a lot of staccato in baroque.
Mm-hmm.
Your bits, pieces.
Would it be a modern baroque?
It's baroque because it's big. Baroque is epic. Any baroque is epic. Look at the architecture. It's all big and bold.
Now, would you say this is rock? Or what? Like, would this be rock music to both? Or what
it, it is rock, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
But when you said, well, did you not mention a couple of weeks ago it was metal?
It's progressive,
progressive
rock.
Metal.
Progressive metal. It's
basically, but metal to me is just noise.
But again, there's a few genres in there. There's a bit of a tribal sound. A lot, bit of synthy. There's a bit of a
transy. Yeah. Is it transy?
But if someone said to me,
it is a bit. Yeah.
Right. Okay.
If someone said to me,
I think,
describe Tool's music.
Yeah.
I would just say, audio art.
Audio
yes.
art. Okay, very nice.
It's just symphonic. Audio art. You know, it's just
it is art. Like,
like you buy an album and you have 20 songs in an album. You get all different genres.
Yeah.
One of their songs does that.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, each song in this new album is 11, 12 minutes. You know, like they're pieces.
And that's a big ask of an audience.
Yeah, it is.
Do you know what I mean?
But again, like that there, it changes.
But it's symphonia.
It changes. Like
exactly.
There's parts. Like it's almost like there's four parts to the one song.
It's opera.
Because what I said, you're waiting what they're going to do next.
Is it
if I was sitting at a concert, at a Tool concert, and they started, I would listen to that part. And then all of a sudden you get up when the next part goes on. And you go back there and you're getting up. That's the way it is.
I wouldn't be standing at a Tool concert.
Well, it's all seated.
Yeah, I would be seated in a very comfortable chair.
Oh.
With a very large gin and tonic. And nobody, actually, I just hire them privately. And no fucker annoying me.
Yeah.
And I just watch them.
I would love, I know we're going to watch it now.
Yeah.
But I would love to see them live.
Oh, yeah.
I would love to just sit.
Why don't we go to Manchester?
Go.
I can't.
There you go. Say, come. You're bringing us.
I was supposed to go to
the I'll pay me own way, though. You just have to lead us by the hand.
Yeah,
I don't do concerts.
I was supposed to go to the Eagles in Manchester, but I can't go. Due to circumstances.
They wrote him a letter.
No,
never again.
They sent a letter to me to say, Paddy, we can't go to see you in the Viper Room. I'm not going to see you.
Fuck them.
Fuck you, too.
So that was a good one?
Yeah. That was, as I say, audio art.
We going to watch that piece now with visuals?
Yes.
I'm intrigued. I
wait
really want to see what they've done.
So everyone listening and watching, we know you all love us. Stay tuned. Part two is coming right up.
Lovely. Yeah. We think we break now.
Sure is. Can't wait.
Can I have some cordial? Because that water tastes like piss.